Walt Disney Records presents Mickey Mouse in Blaggard Castle. It was late at night when Mickey finally returned to his hometown. Worn out, but glad to be back, he unlocked his front door and let himself into the comfortable little house. On a small wooden table near the door, his mail and newspapers from the past 6 weeks were neatly stacked. That day's newspaper was on top. Its bold black headline seemed to scream at him.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Mickey Mouse makes high seas rescue. Find shipwrecked treasure.
Mickey sank his bone-tired body into an overstuffed chair. It had been an action-packed trip, filled to the brim with peril. But finding the treasure and rescuing Captain Church Mouse had made it a complete success. With a smile on his face, he settled back into the chair and instantly fell asleep. The next morning, Mickey went to visit his sweetheart, Minnie. Before he could even say hello, she showed him a newspaper.
Oh, this is full of stories about you. You're a hero.
I wish they wouldn't print that kind of stuff. Too much publicity's liable to get you into trouble.
Perhaps Mickey was right, for in a big, dark castle on the edge of town, two evil-looking men were reading the same paper.
Professor Double X, here's the fellow we need for our experiment.
Right, Professor X. If it works on him, it will work on anybody.
Correct, Professor Double X. And if it does, we will rule the world. We'll get him all right. I'll send him a letter he can't resist.
The next day...
Special delivery for Mickey Mouse.
Gee, thanks. Gosh, must be important. Dear Mr. Mickey Mouse, we are on the verge of perfecting an amazing invention, but we need your help. Come to Blaggard Castle at 10 o'clock tonight. We appeal to you in the interest of science. Do not fail us. Professors X, Double X, and Triple X.
Wasting no time, Mickey took the letter over to his friend, Horace Horsecollar.
What do you make of it, Horace?
I don't know, Mickey. Who are these professors?
Well, I never heard of them. I thought maybe you knew them. And what's more, I thought Blaggard Castle was empty. Did they move in while I was on that treasure hunt?
That's just what bothers me. I've been here all the time, and that castle's still vacant.
Meanwhile, in their secret laboratory at Blaggard Castle, the mysterious professors are using a machine they invented called the Visivox. With it, they can see and hear anything in the world.
What are they doing now, Professor X?
They're talking about our letter. Listen.
It sounds phony to me.
Oh, I'm not scared.
Don't do it, Mickey. Don't go. Maybe they'll hold you for ransom.
But Horace, those professors are scientists. Maybe they really need help. I gotta go.
All right, Mickey, but you may need protection. I'm gonna go too.
Professor X smiled.
Wonderful. Marvelous. If Mickey doesn't survive our little experiment, we'll use Mr. Horsecollar.
Later that night, a fierce storm began to rage as Mickey and Horace drove toward the castle for their 10 o'clock appointment.
There it is, Horace. We're almost there. Gosh, it's a big old place.
Mickey, let's go back. I don't like this.
But those fellas say they got a swell invention, and they need help. We can't turn back now.
All right, Mickey. I'll stick, but I wish we'd said goodbye to Clarabelle and Minnie. We may never see them again.
The two adventurers pulled up to the front door.
Look, Horace. All the shutters are drawn.
Yeah, there don't seem to be anybody here. Sort of spooky, ain't it?
Come on, let's find out what that letter was for.
When Mickey rang the doorbell, a huge trap door sprang open beneath them. They tumbled into the basement, and the trap door slammed shut above them.
Uh-oh.
Well, it's 10 o'clock, and here we are.
Yeah, but now what?
Welcome to Blaggard Castle.
Who said that?
He did.
Horace pointed to a dusty suit of armor in the corner.
Go down this hall and take the first door to the left.
Mickey tiptoed up and peeked inside the armor.
It's empty.
Stop fooling around. Follow directions.
I ain't gonna do it. No pile of junk's gonna order me around. Come on, Mickey, let's go our own way.
Stop. If you do not obey instructions, look what might happen.
Another trapdoor dropped open in the floor in front of Horace.
Great jumping grasshoppers! Look down there, Mickey! Alligators!
Oh, gosh, Horace, I don't like this, but I think we'd better follow those directions.
Through their visivox, the evil professors watched our hero's progress.
They're good and scared now, Professor Double X.
Right, Professor X.
And if we can just get them into the ladder room, they're ours. Look, they're going into it.
Following the directions, Mickey and Horace had walked down the hall and entered the first room on the left. It looked like a dead end, except for a single ladder that rose up through a hole in the ceiling.
I'll see where this ladder goes.
Well, be careful.
Don't worry about me. I won't take no chances.
Horace jumped up onto the ladder. Instantly, it split in two. The floor opened, and Horace and half the ladder plummeted down into the dark.
Whoa!
Mickey leaped for his friend, but the floor quickly shut tight.
Horace, where are you? Oh, gosh, I gotta find him. I just gotta.
Mickey raced out of the room calling for Horace while he looked for a way down to the lower level. While Mickey continued his frantic search through the castle, poor Horace was in the hands of Professors X and Double X. They tied him to a chair in front of a big machine made of glass and metal.
What do you want with me, anyhow?
You are to be the subject of a tremendous experiment. This machine is the greatest invention science has ever known. The hypnotic ray. It hypnotizes people by electricity. And you lucky person, will have the honor of being the first victim.
Well, I ain't looking for no glory. I'd be glad to let somebody else have the honor.
Oh, no, let me explain. You see, everything we see or hear comes in waves. These are of all different lengths. We believe we have produced the shortest wavelength ever created by man, and that this wave will be hypnotic. If it works on you, we can broadcast it and put the whole world in our power. Think of it.
Yeah, I am. That's just the trouble. But if you know all this, why do you need me?
Ah, so far our knowledge is theoretical. When we turn on the machine, if the ray is as short as we think it is, you will fall into a slumber-like hypnosis.
And if it ain't?
Then your brain will cook.
Help! Mickey! Get me out of here! Get me out of here!
At the same time, back across town, Miss Minnie Mouse rushed into Clarabelle's house.
Clarabelle, I'm worried. Mickey has disappeared.
Well, that's funny. So is Horace. Tain't like either of them to go traipsing away without telling nobody.
Oh, Clarabelle, I'm so scared.
They didn't know it, but our hero's sweethearts had good reason to be worried. For at that moment, behind the stone walls of Blaggard Castle, the grand experiment was about to begin.
All right, Professor Double X, turn it on.
All right, Professor X, here it goes.
If this works, we'll be the rulers, kings, emperors of the world.
He ought to be hypnotized by now, Professor X. Give him his instructions.
Horace Horsecollar, you are in our power. You have forgotten all your past life. We are your masters and your only friends. Everyone else is your enemy. All right, Professor Double X, let that thought sink in, and then we will see.
In another part of the castle, Mickey was following his only clue.
I've got a hunch that if I can find that noise, I can find Horace. Aw, swell. Whatever it was, it's quit. What a mess. Horace is probably in trouble, and I can't help him unless I can find him.
Stopping to think, Mickey leaned against the wall, and the stones moved, revealing a handle marked open right, close left.
This is luck. Maybe this'll open a door somewhere.
Mickey pulled the handle right, and the floor dropped open next to him.
The alligator pit! Gosh!
He quickly pushed the handle back. Meanwhile, the professors anxiously questioned Horace to determine the results of their hypnotic ray.
Who are you? What is your name?
I don't remember.
Is he hypnotized or crazy? Ask him something else.
Horace, who are we?
You are my masters and my only friends. Everyone else is my enemy and should be destroyed.
Ooh-wee! It worked. He's hypnotized.
We've done it. The world is ours.
The next thing is to turn Horace loose in the castle and see what he does.
Yes, spring is a beautiful season.
I can hardly wait to turn the ray on the rest of the world.
When you and I were 17 and 4 is 21.
Horace continued to jabber as the professors let him loose in the castle corridors.
The wind was whizzing through the trees. How do the holes get in Swiss cheese?
Just then, Mickey came around the corner.
Horace!
Uh-huh. An enemy.
Horace tackled Mickey.
Whoa! Hey, what's the big idea knocking me down like that?
You are my enemy. My masters told me so.
Your masters? Horace, what's the matter? What have they done to you?
Questions, questions. Always questions.
But Horace!
Chairs have legs, but no knees. Why?
As Mickey continued to try and get through to his babbling buddy, the professors prepared for phase two of the experiment.
Now that we know the ray worked when Horace was directly in front of it, we must reverse the ray to release him from his hypnotism. If, when we zoom in on him with the Visivox, the ray has worked no matter where he is wandering in the castle,
then nothing can stop us. We can hypnotize him again, or anyone, from a distance.
Professor Double X pulled the hypnotic ray lever into reverse. And in another part of the castle...
Oh, my. What happened? Where am I? Mickey! Mickey, save me!
Horace, what's been the matter with you?
I've been hypnotized, that's what. Them professors got a machine and they're gonna hypnotize everybody in the world so they can tell everybody what to do.
How does it work?
I don't know. They set you in front of it, turn it on, and wham! You don't know nothing.
Gosh, if those professors ever turned that thing loose on the world, there's no telling what would happen. What are we gonna do about it?
I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna scram. Come on, Mickey.
No, Horace. We gotta bust that hypnotic ray machine somehow.
You can't do it, Mickey. If you ever get in that room, them professors will turn the ray on you. And then where'll you be?
I've got an idea. When I was searching the castle for you, I spotted something that might help us. Follow me.
Mickey led Horace to a workshop full of tools and odd objects. He picked up a gray pot.
What's that you got?
Well, it's an old pewter pot. And pewter is made mostly out of lead. And since lead'll stop x-rays, I'll bet if I make a helmet out of this, the professor's hypnotic rays won't be able to get to my brain. See?
For gosh sakes.
Now, all I've got to do is cut out some holes for my eyes, and I'm all set.
Mickey picked up a hammer and a chisel and began to work on his pewter helmet.
So, Horace, how do I get into that room to bust up the hypnotic ray machine?
That's just the trouble. You can't get in there. There's only one door, and it's built like a vault. And even then, if you did get past the locks and everything, the whole room is right over the alligator pit, and all around the machine is trap doors. I'll tell you, it's no use.
Well, maybe so, but I'm gonna keep trying.
As Mickey finished up his helmet, the professors were tuning in their visivox.
Look, there is Horace now. He's with Mickey Mouse. What an opportunity.
What do you mean?
He has probably told his friend about our machine. But now we can hypnotize both of them and wipe that knowledge from their minds.
The professors hurried to their machine and turned it on. But just then, Mickey tried on his new helmet.
All done, Horace. How do I look?
You look... Oh, never count your chickens before they cross the road. And a happy new year to you, too.
Horace, what's the matter with you?
Well, don't dunk it in your coffee before you take a little off the top, please.
Mickey pulled the helmet off to get a better look at his friend.
Oh, no. He's hypnotized again. Lucky for me, I was wearing this helmet.
At the same time, the professors ran back to the Visivox to check on their success.
Look, we've failed. It didn't work on Mickey Mouse. It worked on Horace. Why not on Mickey?
I can't understand it.
Is our hypnotic ray a failure?
No, it can't be. There's just one thing to do. We must ask Professor Triple X.
Cautiously, the professors approached a heavy wooden door marked Extremely Private.
I'm afraid to go in. If we tell him we failed, he might injure us.
If we don't tell him, he definitely will.
All right, here goes. Professor Triple X, we bow before your wisdom.
You should.
We come to report that our hypnotic ray is only half successful. It worked on Horace, but not on Mickey.
I know that. I know everything that has ever happened.
Then why didn't it work on Mickey?
Simple. The two have different brain structures, and your machine is not yet perfect. It must be adjusted to deal with all brain types. You must study the brains of Mickey and Horace and see what the difference is.
Yes, but how?
That will be easy. Once I have removed them for you.
A moment later, in another part of the castle...
Gee, Horace, snap out of it, or I'm going to have to capture those professors all by myself.
I hear my master's calling. They want me.
Oh, gosh, Horace, don't go. There's no telling what they'll do to you.
I must go, and what's more, you're going with me.
Who? Me? Ha-ha, nothing doing. Listen, Horace, keep away, please. Stop, Horace. Please
come back
here.
Professors. You are my enemy.
Horace, keep away from me.
Now I've got you. Tag, you're it. Now you chase me.
An astonished and befuddled Mickey watched his friend race away down the hall.
Now that's what I call a horse of a different color. But I gotta help him. And the only way is to find the professors and that machine. Now let's see. Horace said that the hypnotic ray room had trap doors that dropped down into the alligator pit. Well, if a door leads out of a room, maybe it'll lead me into that room, too. The trouble is getting to it.
Mickey went back to the hidden handle in the wall and opened the floor above the alligator pit.
Whew, those professors sure didn't put welcome on the doormat. The trap door is probably under here somewhere, but how will I ever get to it?
Mickey leaned down and peered under the side of the opening to the pit.
Well, what do you know? There's a ledge running around the edge of it. A very little ledge. Well, if I gotta, I gotta.
Mickey hung onto the floor and swung down onto the ledge. It was narrow and covered with slick moss. The alligators all swam over and waited in the water right below him.
Oh, one slip and I'm a goner.
Inching his way along the narrow ledge, Mickey spotted the trap door, but it was out of his reach. Then one of the alligators shimmied up onto the ledge and crawled toward him. Mickey started to move away, but...
Uh-oh! Dead end!
The alligators had him cornered. Slowly and methodically, they plodded closer. Mickey grabbed a long stick that was leaning in the corner and tried to poke the alligators away, but that didn't bother their tough hides. Then he had another idea.
I used to pole vault around the farm. It's my only chance. I've got to take it.
Mickey planted the pole and made a desperate leap for the handles on the trap door. The alligators snapped their jaws at his feet as Mickey sailed across the room above them. Suddenly, the pole began to crack, and at the last possible moment, Mickey lunged for the trap door. Falling through the air, he grabbed the handles and began to spin around. There was a click, and the trap dropped open. Mickey had spun the lock open. Hurriedly but quietly, he crawled up into the laboratory.
Hot dog! I made it! And just in the nick of time.
For at that moment, Horace walked into the lab and was greeted by the professors.
Come right in, Horace.
Yes, people who live in glass houses never count their chickens until the cows come home.
Fine. His condition is perfect. Let the experiment proceed.
There are two sides to everything, especially nails.
The professors led Horace to a table in front of the hypnotic ray machine and started to strap him down. Mickey saw his chance.
Now I'll give those professors some of their own medicine.
He turned on the ray and zapped all three scientists.
Look out!
Get him
out of the way!
Professors, you are hypnotized. I'm your master now. Release the straps on Horace. Gosh, I hope this works.
The three evil inventors turned toward Mickey and stared at him. Then all three dropped to their knees.
Yes, master. Whatever you say.
Whoopee! I got him!
They quickly released Horace, and Mickey led him across the room. Then he aimed the machine at his friend and reversed the ray.
Horace Horsecollar, you are no longer hypnotized. You are free forever.
Where am I?
Horace turned to see the professors rushing toward him.
Mickey, don't let him get me again.
The professors surrounded Horace and began to dance.
Here we go round the mulberry bush so early in the morning.
Well, I guess they're right. It must be morning by now. We'd better finish up here and get on back to town before folks start to worry about us.
A few hours later, Mickey and Horace were home and finishing up the story of their adventure for Minnie and Clarabelle.
And then, that's when we smashed the hypnotic ray machine to smithereens.
That sure felt good.
But what happened to the professors?
Why, they're swell fellas now. We made them forget they'd even heard of a hypnotic ray. And then the sheriff took them to a big laboratory where they'll be inventing things, but they'll be for people instead of against them. And, well, I guess that's about all there is to tell.
Our heroes! Oh, gosh!
And so ends Mickey's scary encounter with the three professors, X, XX, and XXX, in the Blaggard Castle. Let's hope his next adventure is one that is not quite so perilous.